This program originally started back in 2007.
I was there before that.
Come in and just excavate four dirt ponds, unlike what you see today. And then once we add water, it activates. So within 30 seconds per minute, that bowl of eggs, or that bucket of eggs, is fertilized. We then transfer them to one of these jars. We have them labeled. You can see the lot numbers and all that. These are graduated, just like the graduated beaker or cylinder. So we've been tracking the dead eggs versus the good eggs. You'll start to see the development in the eggs. They start to go a little darker color. We put them under the dissecting microscope. We can actually start to see the spine develop in the egg. They're really transparent, full on those eggs. So we'll put, like it'll be half a jar, but by the time we put water to them, they're actually rolling in there, they're moving. We actually have peroxide to cut down on the fungus, because anything in that jar is a vector, and those dead eggs will start to fungus up. And what we was doing is taking the jars and actually hand-picking the good eggs out. We have technicians. Every day we come in, check temperatures, check eggs, make sure everything is flowing, pick the dead eggs off. Every day we're doing that 2 or 3 times a day, just making sure. So from the time we fertilize, as our temperature is about 9, 9.5 to 10, we're seeing enough development. We're seeing some premature hatching here. So you'd see a fly float around the sack lot. Immediately we'd start moving to those tanks because we wanted to hatch force, basically it's called force hatching. Within a 24-hour period, that little jar was hatched. They would come off. A lot of it,
and look at more than just one fish at a time.
Oh yeah, that's a good one.
You can also see that their belly area, which was originally a sack when it was hatched, is now getting skin around it and coloring up to that silvery color. Don't know if they're as transparent now to see their guts, but man, earlier you could just see.
Oh yeah. You want to see the eyes?
Can you see?
Can you see inside? There's a hunter. Is that cool or what?
Pretty cool.
I
part of the program here, now they've swum up, we've got feed on them. So back there in the back, there's 2 or 3 jars that we're hatching the brine shrimp. That takes a full day, 20 to 24 hours for the brine shrimp to hatch. So we're always a day ahead. We come in and you've kind of got those staggered. That's what you're seeing up here. Down here on the floor is the brine shrimp. This is a peristaltic pump again. It's running 24/7. And it's dispensing brine shrimp at a steady drip. So live, you'll see little things dancing in there.
Oh yeah.
Right down here, towards my hand. Water through. So those are brine shrimp. Rotifers are a little more challenging to raise. And we've looked into the literature, but it's a very involved process. We've tried it at our longleaf hatchery, and it takes a lot. I mean, you have to have your water chemistry just right, your pH just right, and you're cropping off the juvenile rotifers, if you will. We've tried it.
And you can see them, they're just going crazy, nuts, they're going to town on us. Into these tanks, and then move them and work them to spawn. But to move them out of here, we'll have to net them out, either use the stocking truck or just, but, and then,